don't know if you can see that. Those are fucking bees.
So, last weekend, I was on a 3-day camping trip, so I wasn't home. And of course, this is when my bees decided to swarm. My neighbor took a video of it, but she said that after about half an hour, it looked like the bees went back into the hive, and they haven't swarmed since. This was a big surprise to me, because I had been checking the hive every week, although since it had been raining much of last week, I didn't inspect them before I left for the trip. And I didn't see any signs of swarming in those previous inspections. So today, I want to inspect the hive and do some detective work to try and figure out what happened. Did the bees really swarm and then come back? Do we have a new queen? Will I see lots of swarm cells? So let's dive right in and open the hive up. Now, if you'll remember, I had added a second brood box in the last video, and that was 2 weeks ago. During that time, it got really cold and wet, so I added a bunch of sugar into that hive, and it looks like the bees have eaten every bit of that sugar. I don't see very much activity in this top box, and in fact, after looking at every frame, not a single one has had even a little wax added to it. So that's really interesting, and in a normal situation, I would have definitely expected the bees to have started working on these frames after 2 weeks. Something definitely went wrong, but I'm not totally sure what. So let's take this box off and look at the main brood box. I'll go ahead and remove the first couple of frames as usual, and it looks like they still haven't been drawn out, so we know the bees haven't been building much comb at all. As I pull out the third frame, I can already feel that it's a lot lighter than it previously was. This frame used to be heavy with capped over honey, and it looks like it's been emptied out. I'm also looking for a queen, eggs, brood, or queen cells, but I don't see any on this frame, so I'll put it back. And as I go to pull out the green drone comb, I hear something peculiar. It's a high-pitched whining sound coming from within the hive. It's really faint on the video, but you might be able to hear it if you listen closely. Anyways, this sound is actually proof that there is a new queen in the hive. You see, when a new queen is born, she needs to make sure that there are no other queens, since a colony can have only one queen bee. This sound is how the queen can find other queens and kill them by stinging them. It's almost a sort of battle cry, since this is a fight to the death, and a queen can even make this call from within her cell before she emerges. As I look over the green drone comb, I don't see any queens, but I do spot what looks like it could potentially be a queen cup. However, after further inspection, I don't see anything in there, so I'll leave it alone for now. I don't see any obvious swarm cells either, so I'm going to move on to the next frame. Now, on this next frame, I spotted an important clue. Using my finger to move the bees around so I could get a better look at the frame, I see a queen cell higher up in the top part of the frame, and it's empty. I take a mental note of that, as it'll be important later when I'm trying to figure out what happened here. As I look more closely at this frame, all of a sudden, I hear that distinctive beeping or whining noise, but much louder than before. I'm certain that there is a new queen on this frame, and I really want to find her. All I have to do is follow my ears since she's calling out, and there she is. But she's gone as quickly as she appeared, as she crawls under some other bees. I'll see if I can get you a better shot of her. Okay, there she is again. Do you see her? Okay, so now we found at least one queen. She's moving pretty fast, and it didn't look like she'd been mated yet, which makes sense, as it can take up to 4 weeks for a newly hatched queen to mate and begin to lay. I'll continue my inspection for now, looking for more clues, and in particular, I'm keeping an eye out for swarm cells. A swarm cell will look kind of like a peanut near the bottom of the frame, and there would usually be many of them. Here's an example of what one might look like. I don't see any swarm cells on this frame, so I'll look at the rest of the frames. As I looked at the rest of the frames, I didn't find any swarm cells, and interestingly, I also didn't find any eggs or larvae. On one of the frames, I did see capped over brood, but that was it as far as new bees. So, carefully, I'll put the hive back together, this time removing the extra brood box I had added. And let's take a moment to consider the clues we found and see if we can figure out what happened. Firstly, I didn't see any swarm cells. That is, I didn't see any queen cells near the bottom of the frame. Secondly, I did see at least one queen cell near the middle upper part of the frame. An important thing to note is that when bees make queen cells in the middle of a frame, it usually means that they are either replacing the queen because she's failing, or they're making an emergency queen because the old queen is already dead. Thirdly, I didn't see any eggs or larvae, but I did see just a bit of capped over brood. Okay, if you think you know what happened, pause the video now and leave a comment down below. So, based on all the clues I found, I think that the bees did not truly swarm in that they did not split the hive to make a new hive, which is something that bees will do normally for various reasons. Instead, I think that the queen must have died somehow between my inspection 3 weeks ago and my inspection 2 weeks ago. There weren't any eggs or visible larvae in the hive at all, but there was capped over brood. Normally, a queen will lay eggs until shortly before the swarm, so I would have expected to at least see uncapped larvae if it was a true swarm. My last hive inspection was 16 days prior to this one, and I actually didn't see the queen in that inspection. The time before that was about 20 days ago, and it normally takes 9 days from when an egg is laid to when it gets capped, and then 12 more days in the capped cell before it emerges as a new bee. Since I did see capped brood, that means that the queen stopped laying eggs between 9 and 21 days ago. It also takes 16 days to hatch a new queen from when the egg is laid. So, if we imagine that about 3 weeks ago the queen died, and the bees made a new queen, she would have hatched about 5 days ago, which is roughly when the bees swarmed. She'd be at the right age to make the piping sound, which is that whining sound we heard earlier, and we'd see just a little bit of capped over brood and no larvae or eggs, which is all true. Now, as to why the bees swarmed like my neighbors saw, well, I'm not totally sure on how to explain that. From my rough timeline, I wonder if the bees thought that it was time to swarm since the new queen was about to hatch, but when no old queen joined them, they returned to the hive? If you think you have a better answer, I'd love to hear about it in the comments down below. As always, if you enjoyed this video, or you want to see more like it, please consider subscribing, hitting the like button, or leaving a comment down below. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.